us for more understanding to the process. Yes. Obviously, when you can meet your parents after the venture. So, that's if you have interest in it.
Okay.
So, to begin with, I want you to understand that we'll take you through what a Turing machine is. We'll tell you how it functions theoretically, and then you'll be given an example as to how the Turing machine works. And then Barnabas will take you to a proposition. But then, as I said, if you are interested, you can meet us after the class. First of all, when you hear a Turing machine, most of you think about an actual computational machine. But a Turing machine is just an abstract mathematical object, which was discovered or worked on by Alan Turing in 1936 when he was working on a project called N-Chanza. And that is a position problem.
So
and when we talk about a Turing machine, it's just a black box, something like this, a black box with tip, with a long tip, with squares inside, equal sides, the squares are the same size. So, and usually it takes a finite number of inputs. So it takes the input, processes, but then this particular thing is either left blank or it has alphabets printed on them. And the usual one that we normal one called the B, which means a blank space. So if I have a blank space, you can have ones or zeros. Usually it's ones and zeros. But then it's a normal thing. So it takes a finite input, so it processes and then gives you an output. So at the end of the processing of this particular Turing machine, if it produces, it may halt or may not halt. So if it halts, it produces you. If it halts, it produces you an output. But in a case where it does not halt, we tell that it's indeterminate. And then the types of operations that are performed by the Turing machine is that it first of all prints a symbol, then afterwards it moves left or right. So if you possibly if you have a symbol here, it can erase the symbol and then print a value. Or better still, if it has no value, it can print a value, then move left or right. And then move to a different stage. Usually we have different states. So it can perform an operation here, then afterwards move to a different state. So usually for each state, what happens here is that first of all, you have to determine the present state of the internal state. And afterwards, it determines the contents in this particular square, then the action taken, then the next internal state. So usually we have quadruples. So and for each quadruple, we have the states. We have the tip symbol. We have the action table. And the game states. And usually when the current state and then the tip symbol will determine whether it actually terminates or not. So in a case where the state and then the tip symbol has no quadruple for it to perform, then it terminates. So it looks at the state and then tip symbol. So for each process, it will look at the state, the tip symbol, the action taken, and then the new step to work. So the new state it will take. So you perform that operation over and over again. And then if it gets to a state where the state and then the tip symbol cannot be found in any of the quadruples, then it's false. So I'll stop here and then let's. Let Dalma take you through an example. Thank you.